Okay, guys, so, great, so before we begin, I'm gonna set my expectations, even though I know you guys are experts at this, you don't even need a reminder, but we're sitting in our best sport, your boards and markers are not to be touched, and you're doing your best thinking, of course. Hand check. Awesome. Okay, so we've been working on multi-step problems and how to accurately create a game plan. So, amazing mathematicians, they read the problem 2 or 3 times, every single time. What else do great mathematicians do? Darna.
The way mathematicians do that, they first they read the problem.
Okay, so we know, right? They read the problem 2 or 3 times. But what else do they do?
They underline the important parts.
Underline important parts, absolutely. Brielle.
And then they make the game plan.
They make a mind movie, absolutely. What else do great mathematicians do? Think deeply. Eric.
They also act the problem out.
They act the problem out, absolutely. And one more, Jesus.
They split
the page. Some of you are missing really important things we've gone over in this class. See, I'm gonna give you a few seconds to think. 5 people have their thumbs up. 6 people have their thumbs up. 7, 8. Amberly.
Great mathematicians always make a model and then make another sentence that matches the model and their mind movie.
Beautiful! Kiss your brain. Amazing. Give 2 claps, Amberly. So, great mathematicians use a model and a number sentence that matches their mind movie. Great. So, let's read this problem together. As we're reading it together, you should be using all of these things we just mentioned, but most importantly, acting it out as I read it all out. Mr. Inslee has 8 bins with 21 nonfiction books in each bin. Ms. Schuler has 128 nonfiction books. How many more nonfiction books does Mr. Inslee have than Ms. Schuler? We are going to turn and talk. What are you picturing now? Turn. What are you picturing in your mind movie? Talk. Jesus, turn your body to Jesus. What are you picturing in your mind movie? In your own words.
What I'm picturing in my mind movie is that there's 8 bins with 21 nonfiction books inside each bin.
What else are you picturing? Turn your body to Zaniah.
I'm picturing Ms. Schuler having 120 nonfiction books.
Okay. And Brielle?
And then I noticed that it says how many more nonfiction books does Mr. Inslee have more than Ms. Schuler, then that means that Mr. Inslee has more nonfiction books.
Oh, interesting, Brielle. Okay, turn your body in 3, 2, 1. Hand check. All right, beautiful. So, now that we've made our mind movie, let's read the problem one more time because the best mathematicians read it at least
2 to 3 times.
Mr. Inslee has 8 bins with 21 nonfiction books in each bin. Ms. Schuler has 128 nonfiction books. How many more nonfiction books does Mr. Inslee have than Ms. Schuler? Hand check. Great. I'm going to give you 4 minutes. You will reread it one more time independently, and then you will make your model and your number sentence that matches your mind. What are you going to do? Jada.
You're going to independently read and
then you're gonna draw a model, and make another sentence that matches your model.
Beautiful. Focus your brain. You have 4 minutes. Love how Elijah's reading it for the third time. Darnell's cracking it out to make sure he's pulling up all important information. Kai is reading carefully and slowly. Two more minutes. Sadhu is labeling every single part of his game plan. Okay, you have 30 seconds left. Okay, you have 10 seconds. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, one, place your boards and your markers down. Waiting for two scholars, waiting for one scholar. Beautiful. Hand check. All right. I now want you to turn and talk with your partner. Agree or disagree with their game plan? Why? Turn. Agree or disagree with their game plan and why? Talk.
Girl, I'm not going to be able to do it.
try now. Did you agree or disagree with Amberlee's game plan?
I agree with Amberlee's game plan because this rule that she put one as 21. She put that she said that this not one non-fictional. So that one in each bin. So, but there's 8 of them. So I still agree because she just represented one to show the 8 were.
Okay, some of you chose to represent it in this way. 8 bins, labeled 8 bins. How many books in each bin?
21.
Okay. Amberlee chose to display it as one box, but next to it she put 8 bins with 21 books in each bin. Let me just show the number. There you go. Beautiful. So, Amberlee, can you take the teacher chair? Alright, Amberlee. Let's take a look at your number sentence. We just discussed your model. Can you explain to me your number sentence?
My number sentence is parentheses 8 times 21.
Interesting. Why did Amberlee do 8 times 21? Why did she multiply 8 and 21? Turn your body to Fatu.
Amberlee.
Hold on, Fatu. You don't have 100% respect.
Amberlee did 8 times 21 to find the total of Mr. Easley's books because they're trying to find out who has more. I mean, how many more books does he have than
Miss S or Miss Schubert? Absolutely. We need to find out what the total number of books Mr. Inslee has. So, 8 represents?
The 8 bins.
21 represents?
The 21 books in each bin.
Beautiful. Hand check. Great. So, we know that we need to find the total number of books Mr. Inslee has. What did you do next, Amberlee?
Then, I wrote minus 128.
Why? Why did Amberlee write minus 128? Turn your body to isosceles.
Amberlee wrote minus 128 because we're comparing and if we're comparing, we need to subtract because we want to see.
Love that. How? What are we comparing in this problem? Let me show the problem. What are we comparing, Isata? Actually, what are we comparing, Jelly's?
We are comparing how many Mr. Inslee has.
How many what? Elephants?
How many nonfiction books do Mr. Inslee has than Ms. Schuler? Because if we just put 8 and 21, we won't know how much nonfiction books Mr. Inslee has in total. And now we're comparing who has more, and we're comparing who has more, Mr. Inslee or Ms.
Yeah, so we needed to find the total of Mr. Inslee's books because then we need to compare Mr. Inslee and Mrs. Schubert. Who has more books? Okay. All right, and then continue.
Then I wrote equals N.
So, Chaylisa's sitting in sport, Erica's sitting in sport, Setsu is now sitting in sport.
Then I wrote equals N.
And what does that N represent?
The N represents the books that
So, what positive feedback can you give Amberlee here? What did she do that was very effective in her game plan? Ria.
She did that.
I love how Sahara turned her entire body to Ria.
At first, when she did her model, instead of putting a lot of boxes and that wasted a little bit of time, she put one box,
Yep, she was very efficient. One more. What else? Turn your body to Jada.
And she also labeled, so she could understand. Like what each thing.
Absolutely. She labeled every single part of her model, of her number sentence, to make sure that she didn't make any precision errors. Absolutely beautiful. Hand check. So what feedback then can you give Darnell's game plan? Turn to Darnell and give him feedback. Eric. Yep. Why is that helpful, Darnell?
The reason why I should read my work because if somebody would read my work, and they would think that I would think that the problem, they would read the problem first, and then they would think that I don't have the right units for the problem.
Yeah, but why else, Darnell? Think deeply. Why else could you? It was that help, that feedback help for you?
Because now that I know when I label,
who can help Darnell? Jesus.
You can get confused when you're adding or something.
Right. So you don't make any little silly mistakes, any precision errors. You don't get confused, and then you know what every single number in your game plan represents. Hand check. So what do great mathematicians do today and every day? Who has not participated yet? Adam.
The thing that great mathematicians do every day is that they read the problem 2 or 3 times and make sure they have a complete and labeled game plan. And in order to do that, they go back to the story and think, do they have all the important parts?
Absolutely. Kiss your brain. Give 2 claps to Adam. When you get back to your desk, you must do everything that Adam just mentioned. All right, let's see, friends. Who's going to transition us to our desks? Nakai, loud and proud.
1, get ready. 2, stand up.